What's up, everybody? A Spare with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on Subnautica. When we left off in the last episode, I bit off a lot more than I could chew by trying to get into the lava zone, not even realizing that you need the prawn suit, because I'm pretty sure, I'm not 100% positive, but I'm pretty sure that even with the max compensator, I don't think the sea moth can go down that far. So you need the prawn suit to be able to explore outside of the Cyclops, and because when I tried it without there being any heat shield between me and the lava, yeah, I kind of kept lighting myself on fire, which was not pleasant. So, yeah. Now, today's probably going to be a little bit of a strange episode. I mean, go figure, it's me, right? But, no, actually, what I'm really getting at is, I've had some personal stuff going on in the background behind my channel stuff, and I really haven't had the time available to me to sit down and put as much time into my videos as I normally do, and I'm sure you guys have noticed that before, but, so, honestly, I'm trying to get as much done as I can in as little time as possible, and where I had said we were going to go off exploring and gather stuff to make the suit, I just don't think I have time to do all of that off-camera work today.
Welcome aboard,
so,
Captain.
What am
all
I...
systems online.
What am I doing, by the way? I'm using the Cyclops' fabricator when I've got a renewable source right here, dummy. I wonder what would happen, actually. Can you put, like, a power cell or a battery charger in here? Because that... I think I tried that before already, and I don't think you can. Let's cook up the bladder fish into water first. So, yeah, I think what I'm going to focus on today is maybe some base expansion and some cleanup, like getting more organized and things like that, more so than gallivanting about. Let's see. Did I eat the raw one? I ate the raw one. Good for me. Good job there, buddy. Energy pulse origin. We got more ion clusters. I don't think I have anything in here, right? Good. Alrighty. So yeah, we have our base kind of expanding a little bit, which is cool. But I'd like to take it a little bit further. And one thing that I actually did not know about, that apparently I've had on me this whole time, I mentioned before about this is kind of inconvenient to try and walk around, you get all this weird clipping stuff and everything. I got a comment in my last video on these guys, the potted plants. I've never even used these before, but I totally should be using them. Oh crap, I didn't mean to do that. I do sometimes wish there was a crouch button. Because it seems like if you're standing on top of the thingy-ma-bobber, it doesn't really want to go anywhere. For now? I don't know. This one kind of looks like a dog bowl. Come on. And it also seems a little more finicky. So let's see what this does. Oh, now this is interesting to me. Because apparently I can put four in here, right? But I don't think they're going to be as big, because these take up... Well, they only say marble melon seeds. But when you pick them up, there's four. That's interesting. That's very interesting, because... yeah, when you grab one of these, it's... Well, and keep in mind, we also saw the smaller... We also saw smaller marble melons things, too. So, I don't know if that's... I don't know if that's gonna work for me or not. Oops. Did not mean to do that. We're gonna find out, though. Really quick. And it would be at least convenient, if nothing else, mainly because I don't have to keep tripping over it all the time. We can actually just walk through here and it's fine. Yay! That's so cool. Our creep vine's doing okay. And you know what? I haven't really checked our... Wait a minute. Where's... This is the modification station, right? Where's all my... like, oxygen tank ones and stuff? Did they take that out? Propulsion cannon... they took it out, it looks like. It used to... You used to be able to do... the heat knives, the swim charge fins, the reinforced... I'm confused. That was the mod station, right? Yeah. Huh. I just noticed that. I just noticed that they took that out. Well, I'll be darned. Yeah, they took out the swim charge fins, the expanded O2, like the hardened or reinforced O2 tanks and stuff. Interesting. I did not know they did that. We have our emergency. I would like to point out, I do think it's rather funny that the emergency food supply is coffee and chips or snacks. It's not like some vegetable paste thing that keeps you healthy. No, no, the emergency food supply is junk food and coffee. What could possibly go wrong? Magnetite, I don't think I have any of that. I don't think we've really needed a power situation either. That hasn't really become much of an issue at this point. I should probably do... We could probably get a little RP with this and make like a living quarters at this point. That might be a cool experiment. Can I connect from in here? I don't think I can. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna let me. We gotta do this from outside, I think. Okay. Let's see what we got. I could also branch off and go this way too, but... or that way. Actually, how much space does these rooms take up? I could actually do that. That might not actually be a bad idea. Let's try that. So, if I can highlight you, attached components must be deconstructed for... Oh, crap. Well, that's not gonna happen. Oh, wait. There it goes. Wait, no, that's the reinforcement. Dang it. Basic compartment. Wait, is it the reinforcement that's doing that? Okay. Darn, I don't think I have any lithium on me, though. Or, wait, yes I do. I think I do have extras somewhere in one of these things, maybe? Ah! I got a lithium. Alright, what's a reinforcement? Perfect. We got it. Do I have any extra titanium laying around? Doesn't look like it. I still had fish in there for like emergency fish stuff. Let's put one here for now. And really I'm just doing that to take the edge off of this one so I can see if I can break it, because I'm gonna put it right back. Now, can I break you down? Drat. Well, how come I can break this one down? Oops. That's attached to a... It's attached to two things. Maybe it's this? Maybe it's the foundation? Wait. I can dismantle the bioreactor from in here? From under here? That was weird. Pretty sure that came up and said bioreactor. Bulkhead. Wait. Where is it? What am I dismantling? Silicone rubber. Oh, you dummy. That was the door. Wait, is that... That was what was doing it. Oh, there was a bulkhead in there. What a... I'm thinking of a word for myself. What a derp. I'm over here like, I don't know why I can't do that one, but I can do this one. I definitely want to put that reinforcement back. I am wondering about glassifying some of this stuff, though. We don't have a T-junction, though. So that's not gonna work. I still could always do one of my... Well, no, actually, I can't, can I? Because I was thinking of doing another one of my patented... Because I have enough for this, but it won't let me do it. I was thinking of doing another one of those patented reinforcement cells that I came up with in the last... in the last series. But... now they've got it to where it won't work. Because they can't... you can't do the terraforming. So I could do it, but I just have this giant pillar. It would be rather unsightly. And it's not really necessary at this point. Screw it. We've got one there. Let's just put another reinforcement over here for now. We can always change it. Okay. Now, can I put a room... Wait, why not? Why can't I put a room off of this? It's right there. Why won't you do? Why you no do? Huh. Interesting. Well, that changes things. Let's do... Wait, rotate. Why aren't you rotating? Oh, gotta do the mouse wheel. It's not Q and E anymore. Well... Oh, they finally did it to where you can go vertical. Oh, cool. Can I put you up here? Why not? Maybe I have to go one more? Full disclosure, not really sure exactly what I'm doing or how I'm going about it. I can put one up here, apparently, but not there. Why? Here's a question. Is it this thing's fault? It doth appear to be this thing's fault. That's really weird. You can just make, like, floating ones now. That's kind of funky. Like, I could just put one out here. I mean, it's kind of cool, but it's kind of weird. If I take this down? Can I put one up here? I can. Now can I put you here? I can. Well, that just doesn't make any sense at all. If I've got the room, I can put the vertical thing, but if I don't have the room, I can't put the vertical thing. Wait, let's just double check and make sure. Yeah, no. Okay. It didn't work. Huh. Well, I was trying to figure out a way to get a ladder up to another room and make it a little more multi-dimensional. But that does not seem to be something it wants to do. Can I just attach a ladder, maybe? No. Alright, here's another idea. Here's another one. Let's try and put a vertical tube with a ladder and then see if it'll let me do that. Because I'm trying to just add some diversity to the building, so it's not just all one flat dimensional thing, but we can get some stuff going on. Ooh, hello. Marble melon. I'll be darned. It does work. Holy crap. And you get just as many seeds? Why the heck haven't I been doing that from the get-go? Dummy me. Look at that. We got, like, more food and water than we'll ever need. I'm gonna do that in the, whatchamacallit? Cyclops. Sea view. Those things. And it won't let me put a ladder there unless there's a room. I mean, don't get me wrong. I know how you're supposed to do this. I'm trying to do some different things just to give it some... pizzazz. I know you're supposed to do another room on top of this and put a ladder in there. I just don't want to do it that way because that's just the way you're supposed to do it and that's no fun. I don't know why I can't put one here, to be quite honest. Like, there's nothing really in the way of the blueprint thingy. Even though the other room is close to it, it's not really there, so I don't quite understand that one. What else do we have that we work with? I would like to make everything kind of glass again. That was kind of fun. But a lot of work. A lot of work. So maybe not. Poo. I don't want to have to go through all that to get to the captain's court. You know what? Screw it. We're gonna throw a solar panel. Maybe on top of the moon pool room. That's probably not going anywhere anytime soon. Hey, I wonder if you can do... Actually, no. Let's throw it over here. Like, just somewhere out of the way. Right? Like, right there. That ought to do. Why not? I also did read somewhere in the change logs and stuff that a lot of solar panels could also be the reason that I was having frame rate lag. So that's possible. That's another option. Can I put like a room on top of this? Apparently you can, but is there any point where you can add a ladder to it to get up there? It's an interesting dilemma. Now this one won't let me. Huh? That doesn't make any sense. This one won't let me do it, but a big room I can put on top of there. Well, that just don't make no sense. Oh, and now you're not letting me either. It was letting me a minute ago, wasn't it? Or did I not try this one? Maybe I didn't try it. Alright, well, there's a couple other things I want to work on, and maybe in moving some stuff we can figure it out. One thing I want to try to do is make a different area separate from my base that's going to be used for outdoor farming, or underwater farming, rather. I don't really want to have it just floating out here. Well, I guess it doesn't matter, does it? Because the struts will auto-adjust themselves, won't they? So let's just put it right there. Well, oh, there they go. I was going to say they're supposed to auto-adjust themselves. Okay, and we'll do a couple of grow beds. Because it occurred to me in the last episode, there's no real reason to have these plots, like, being affected by the base when they're not really... They don't draw power or anything like that. That's not really necessary. So it makes kind of more sense to just have them be their own thing. Okay, we've got room over here. So what we're going to do is grab a bunch of these creepvine seeds until we have enough... Oh, my inventory's full, you dummy. Okay, that was new. We're going to do that so that we can clear the amount of stuff here. Because I'm wondering if that's what's keeping me from building a room there, is that there's creep vines on in the way of the building. Okay. And plus, this will kind of be a reserve power source thing since we're running off a bioreactor anyway. And it'll get this weird yellow glow thing out of my base. Because there's so many of these plants here that there's just like a ton of them in the base. Or a ton of this glow, it's just everywhere. And actually, if I'm being really efficient, I probably should turn the rest of these that I don't use into lubricant or rubber or something. Maybe a little bit of both. I don't really know that I want to take the time, nor am I really worried about it, since we're improving the number of plants that we're going to have. So I'm not... Because we just actually upgraded to two... Or from two to three. So for now, for this episode, I'm just not really worried about it. Can I just deconstruct this? And it deletes the plants. Perfect. Awesome. And like I said, I know if I was being super efficient that, you know, I should have loaded up the bioreactor or stored the stuff somewhere, but this is still using this. It hasn't even gotten to it because I haven't been doing much with the power, and you can see that it's running fine. And I don't really need any rubber or lubricant at the moment, so yeah, we're just gonna leave that. And then of course, as we get other plants and things, we could plant them out here, we could expand this platform, move it, whatever, but it will keep it from... Okay, and I can't get rid of those platforms because there's too much stuff going on here. I probably should make a storage area, or a storage room, and a ready room. Oh, come on! I thought you were supposed to be able to double up these now. Can I not do that anymore? Is that not a thing? Whoa! That was weird. Alright, these actually aren't connected, so that's not what I want. Okay, I don't know why it's not letting me do that. Oh, maybe it's the... Yeah, okay, it's the bioreactor. Duh. Didn't even think about that. The bioreactor in the middle of the room is probably keeping me from doing that. So what we could do... This is my theory. This will be the entry point. We could do another room... Maybe. There we go. We could do another room out here. And make this the bioreactor room, or nuclear, or whatever. See, why can't I place that? I have enough titanium. What's in its way? I'm telling you, man, this stuff is getting a little finicky for me. They took out terraforming, and now it's like it can't seem to compensate. But there's nothing really in its way. I don't get that. Whatever. Though, I will say that might actually add some dynamic form to all the builds and stuff, because you're having to work around terrain like this. We can't just go straight out, so you'd have to go up one and over or out that way. You know, so you're kind of having to cater to the room or in the terrain. Now, if we do this, can I go off of this now? There we go. So let's put that there. Now let's see if I can put... Wait, I don't have enough, but that's fine. I can at least see if it'll place... Okay, so that'll place there. So what I'm thinking is this will be the power. Since it's the room we use the least, this will be, you know, food and water, and then this can be our storage. We'll move all the storage stuff from this one. This will be the entryway slash, you know, garden, food, maybe something like that, and then we'll come up one here and do a captain's quarters type thing, or yeah, something like that. Observatories have to come off of an edge, don't they? It looks like. I don't think they can go from the top and bottom. I think they have to come off of that side point. Okay. Now, let's see. Those will take a minute to grow.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
So, I might not want to move this just yet. How much... Okay, perfect, I have three. Let's put the entry point over here. That'll probably be the most out of the way, I think. This is a little bit of a cramped space. I do hope at some point maybe they scale the aquarium back just a touch so it's not quite so cramped, because you kind of clip as you walk through here and you snag the handrail, or take the handrails off. That's the other option. Because you can, like, walk through here with no problem. I do like this, too. This is a cool... Whoa. Huh? That's a bug. Your animations and stuff get all weird. Oh, no, that's funky. If I'm walking, it just works. If I look down, I, like, slide. That's weird. Okay, and then this will lead out to the room where the power, the reactor is. So all of these walls, I'm thinking, will end up being storage lockers. That's kind of what I'm thinking. And we'll probably start with these edge points. Because if we do... And actually, this... Ooh, I just got an idea. This could be... one of our... structure points. And what I mean by structure is reinforcement points. So what I mean by that, ooh, that's cutting it close, is we can put the reinforcements in the corner here, because the corners you can't use for pathways anyway. Yeah, so we'll move those to the four corners of it. Now, you can use them for glass, which is why I didn't put them down here with the aquarium, because at some point I might do the aquariums with glass windows, but we'll need at least one or two with reinforcement points. But since that's going to be storage, we can put, you know, you're not going to put windows on those points anyway, because it would cover up your, you know, access to storage, so you wouldn't want to do that. Let me grab this, and we're just going to take this one with us, and we'll start our migration process. But that's kind of what I'm thinking, is since you can't really use the areas that you're putting storage lockers on anyway for, like, windows, we can just go ahead and use this room for the reinforcement spot, and then you can have glass there, glass wherever else you want. Because I do think that is a big visual appeal to Subnautica, is the idea of you're living underwater and you can just look out and look at the water. I think that's a really cool effect, and it's very, very visually striking, if you will. I have a lot of gold, and I need to find something to use it on, by the looks of things. I'm just going to throw that in there for now. What is that thing? I just noticed. Oh, I have a creature egg. I should probably make another aquarium at some point for, like, experimental. Since this is food and that's water, I should probably have, like, an experimental one. Now, I don't really fully understand the breeding mechanics, so I don't know if I really want to do this, but I could consolidate and put the bladderfish in this tank by putting a second tank up here. I could do that. I don't know how that would affect this kind of thing of your ability to walk through the area, but that's something we could actually end up doing. I'm just kind of dumping all of the stuff that I'm not using, and we'll go through it later at some point, because with proper organization, or with enough lockers and stuff, we could actually organize it a little bit better. Okay, that means I emptied this one and totally forgot to deconstruct it, which is just kudos on my part. And we're just going to grab all of this stuff, kind of emptying them as we go. So yeah, hopefully next episode I'll have a bit more time to work on some stuff. Honestly, there's just been some things going on. My dog's been having some medical stuff that has had me or my mother or somebody in the house has to keep an eye on him at all times, basically, or else he has like a sore thing and he makes it worse because he just chews on it. He's a dog. So basically, between that and there's been some stuff going on with my brother that he's needed help with some things, my brother and my uncle and stuff like that. So there's just been a lot of cascading kind of things going on. personally. Not real bad or anything, just life, just events and things, and we're all just kind of, we're kind of a close-knit family, so we're all trying to just kind of work around and help everybody out and make sure everything's, you know, squared away and everybody's got everything taken care of. But that means there are times where nobody can watch him, so I have to watch the dog, which, it's fine, he's my dog, I don't care. But, you know, it cuts into how much time I have to record each episode, or what days I can record if they're going to be gone, or when I try to record because they're going to be gone the next, you know, just all that stuff. I mean, short version is there. I'm clearing my hot bar. So, short version, a lot of my episodes lately have probably been a little bit cut short or a little less organized or not as much progress done. Pick one, basically. But the short version is just because there's been a lot of just activity. Nothing really inherently bad or, you know, over-the-top crazy of like, oh my gosh, I can't believe you're still doing... You know, it's not really that big of a deal. It's just, you know, stuff that you gotta do. And everything got reorganized. So, you know, I do apologize for that if some of you have been watching kind of my stuff and been like, hey, well, why is everything seeming like there's no transitions and there's no cut work and all that kind of stuff? That's why. Short version. So... yeah, hopefully in the next week or two that'll kind of clear up and it won't be an issue anymore. How did I manage to do that? I don't have enough room for a fourth locker? I should. I'll have to empty and readjust some of them. But so yeah, on that regard, I do apologize for the abruptness, is probably a good word, of some of my episodes as of late. I had mentioned a while ago, you know, kind of streamlining and consolidating my channel work so that, I wouldn't have to do that and I'd be able to spend more time on each episode. But the other factor is I also did that so that I could spend more time on projects, and my book's coming along a lot better than I was originally anticipating, but it's also become a bit more of a bigger project. It was originally envisioned to be a bit smaller than it's turning out to be, but as I'm writing it and it's fleshing itself out and I'm being descriptive with stuff and trying to explain everything accurately and whatever and what else, you know, that's the biggest part of storytelling is, you know, you have to have a good story, but if you can't describe it or explain it properly, you know, it's not really going to resonate or work. So in trying to make sure everything's really explained and very detailed picture so you get the right image of what all's going on, the book itself has kind of expanded a little bit and gotten a little bit larger than I originally anticipated. I mean, it's not going to be a Game of Thrones novel or anything like that, but it did get a little bit to be bigger in scope and events and stuff than I had originally anticipated it. So anyways, that said, we actually did make some pretty decent progress on expanding the base. We got our lockers moved. Not organized, but moved. And actually, we'll just go ahead and throw these in there, too. And got our creepvine farm relocated. And the... actually, we can put, like, luggage things right there. Place. Thank you. Oh, it just auto grabs? Oh, that's cool. I didn't know it did that. So yeah, got our storage stuff moved over, and the setup is in place for the new power source area. Let me know what you guys think as far as moving this. I could actually move this and put all of them in there. I just don't know if then when I clear it out, are the peepers going to overbreed to where then I don't have any more space for the bladderfish again? Because they seem to breed a little bit slower than the other one. Is there a boomerang fish in there? Oh, no, he's right there. I don't know how he got in there. Rah, just ate him raw. So, yeah, and we also consolidated our marble melon thing, which is a great idea. I really need to do this in the sea view because they're so much more compact. You could do two of these and get eight plants. Just, I'm pretty sure that's about the same you'd get from the other one. Our creep vine's growing in. Looks good. Almost there. So yeah, I think we did pretty good. Actually, you know what? I am going to get rid of this because it's rather unsightly until I get enough resources to put that together. So yeah, I think we're going to wrap things up here for this episode. In the meantime, I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. Peace!